Hi guys, welcome back to my channel IT Pro Teams, and today we will go further with Veeam Backup. So if you remember in my previous video, I have given a detailed installation and configuration of Veeam Backup solution for Office 365. Today I would like to show you how basically we can expand this backup infrastructure and try to create multiple repository. And if we have to create a backup repository for the backup jobs in the cloud, then how we are able to do it. So if you can go see here in the my backup proxy server, I have a backup repository which currently pointing to the local systems only, local disk only. Right. So that is a default repository, right? So if I want to create a repository in the cloud, first I need to add in a cloud storage here, and Veeam will allow to add the options for multiple cloud storage. Either it's an Azure-based storage or AWS-based or a third-party service providers. So first, I will show you how I can add an object storage from the cloud. So let me go back to my cloud. So I have this Azure subscription with me, and under the Azure subscription, I have created a storage account. Under that storage account, I have created one, right, container for my blob storage. And under this container, I want to basically upload the copy of the backup. Right, so I have created this Veeam O365 backup, right, container. And I'm going to save one copy of the backup data into this Azure blob storage. So how we are going to do that? So the first thing, we just go back here in the Veeam Backup, right? We right click here, and then there is an option called Add Object Storage. When I click on this option, it will ask me what would be the name of that object storage. So I said it Veeam Azure Blob. Then I click Next. And then there are options. There are S3 compatible, Amazon S3, Microsoft Blob Storage, IBM Cloud Object Storage, and WebC Cloud Storage. So I'm going to select Microsoft Azure. Click Next. Now there are options, Blob Storage and Archive Storage. So select the Blob Storage. Click Next. Now it asks me how you're going to get this container information. So you just click here. And then there are two options that you need, right? One is the account name, second is the shared key. Let me show you how you can get these two information. So if you go here in the storage, then you can click on this security and networking segments, and you click here, right? And under that, you are able to get your storage name, and then here you can able to see the key. Once you click on the show, you are able to see the key here, right? Okay, and then you can able to it's hide, but you are able to copy it from the clipboard. So first you copy this, right? Then you go back here, you place the storage account information, then you go click here, go back here and copy this key back here, paste it here, and this is the way you are able to, right, get it here. Once you are selecting this Hello Azure Blob Storage here, click Next. It will ask you to do a container. Which container? So I already created a container for Veeam O365 backup. We are going to select that container. So there are two options. One option is called if you can basically want to log the container, immutables. then you can choose this. So it cannot be, if we are going to protect it, then though ransomware hackers or malicious, they're not able to reach to that. But that is not a writable. You cannot able to write, you cannot able to modify, even you are not able to delete it. So I'm not doing that. So I have Veeam backup container. If you want, you just browse here and then you can create a folder. So if you can create a new folder, I'm creating it for O365 backup. I've created this folder here and I'm selecting this folder. Click OK. You have selected the folder. And if you want to set a restrictions, you can click here and set the size limit. I'm not selecting it as of now. Click next. Then it will ask you if you have an archiver appliance or application if you want to create, right? I don't want to use any archiver, so which can automatically move the data from my blob storage to archive storage as of now. So you just finish it. Now, once I finish it, if you can see that there is an object container created here. So now how the data can be saved, right, into this container, right? So first thing, you have to go to your backup repository and you have to add one repository here. So you just name it, right, Azure backup. Okay. Next. So now there is an option, backup to the object storage, right? Click next. Then it will ask you the path from where it will go. You can create a path here, right? Azure backup. Okay. Next. Then it will ask you which blob storage you want to do. So I want to use this Veeam Azure Blob Storage. If you want to encrypt the data, you can select this and provide the password. I'm not encrypting it as of now. Click next. Now you can select the retention of this particular period, how long you want to keep that data in the blob storage. So I am selecting a snapshot based retention, or you can have an item level retention also. Let me go with the snapshot and finish. Now it will create a repository here, and that repository will basically take the data, backup data, and save that data to the Azure. Now the question is that how you are going to take the data. Okay, so for that you have to go back to your organizations, and here you can see I have run a backup job, right? So this is my backup job, and once I have done a backup job, right, I have the options to create a copy of that backup job. So when the backup job done, and the let me create a job here. So I'm going to create a backup job, and I'm giving it for, let's suppose I'm creating it for OneDrive or SharePoint or whatever, and then I will add the object, and I'm going to add the site, right? Let me expand it and select a particular person site. If you want to see how to add an organizations, you have to watch my previous video. Okay, let me select one of the user, right? Next, right? I'm not excluding anything. Now here you can see, right? We have an option, right? If you want to save this data directly to Azure, you can select it, or you want to save it in the on-prem, you can save it, right? Now I'm doing it here and I'm starting a backup job. Now the backup job is created. So within few minutes the backup job will be create and the data will be saved inside the OneDrive. Data will be saved inside the local storage, right? But there's an option if you want to do it, right? Instead of here, you can able to directly do it inside your. So I have choice. I can do it here, or I can edit this, right? And then I can go here and choose this one. Right, it will ask you a full backup can be performed. Right, so click next, and then you can start a job. Very soon, this will be created. And if you can go to your Azure Blob Storage under the this container, you'll able to see there's a folder created for Veeam. Right, and the data start coming for backup 365, and then you can able to see there's a Microsoft 365 backup, and under that you'll able to see the entire data. Thank you guys for watching this video. Please like, subscribe and share my channel, and very soon I will show you updated video in the same series. Thank you.